When you introduce yourself, do you call yourself a sea monster biologist?
No, I just say, hi, I'm Lewis.
Dr. Lewis Jacobs is a vertebrate paleontologist at Southern Methodist University. He and his colleague, Mike Polson, study ancient marine reptiles from the time of the dinosaurs, or as they call them, sea monsters. These are the long-necked plesiosaurs that look like the Loch Ness Monster, and the giant mosasaurs that you might be familiar with from Jurassic World. I met up with Jacobs and Polson at the Smithsonian's National Museum of Natural History while they were installing sea monster fossils in a new exhibit.
All right, Lewis, set the scene for us. What was the world like when these marine reptiles were alive?
Oh, well, for one thing, the South Atlantic Ocean was only half as wide as it is now.
You see, Africa and South America used to be connected, but over millions of years, the two continents pulled apart, leaving the South Atlantic Ocean between them.
And finally, at about 90 million years ago, you have enough ocean water circulating through that not only did it make the conditions good enough for our sea monsters to come in and live, but that water going out into the world ocean cooled off the whole world ocean.
Wow.
And helped to change the climate and the ocean environment of that time.
The formation of this ocean could actually affect the entire globe.
It did.
Giant marine reptiles called mosasaurs had been living up near the tropics. But when this ocean opened up, the sea monsters migrated south. This new arrangement of the continents and the prevailing winds created an upwelling area, raising nutrients from the ocean floor that attracted prey animals and their predators. This brought so many sea monsters to the waters around Angola that scientists have found a huge treasure trove of fossils there. Here's a new species they found called Prognathodon kionda.
How big would this guy have been from like nose to tail?
Yeah, so this particular species may have reached 25, 27 feet long.
Pretty incredible.
Yeah.
The largest mosasaurs could have reached up to 50 feet. And these guys had huge appetites. In this particular specimen's stomach are the fossilized remains of three other mosasaurs, including one of the same species.
This guy has only nipped off parts of these animals. So this is just the snout of the other Prognathodon and the first reported case or documented case of cannibalism in a mosasaur.
So crazy!
It is.
Extremely well-preserved specimens like this can also tell scientists how these animals swam. We know they moved their tails from side to side, kind of like a shark. And by looking at CT scans of certain mosasaurs' brain cases, the scientists have seen some of these animals' balance organs. The fossils paint a picture of animals that were agile swimmers, many of whom were fast predators.
What would you compare them to that's a living creature today?
So it would be comparable to large toothed whales today. So, you know, approaching something like an orca.
Oh, wow.
Similar to whales, these animals come from a lineage that evolved on land and made their way back into the water. Except mosasaurs evolved from lizards rather than mammals. You know, people like to say that history doesn't repeat itself, but it rhymes. And while the world of the Cretaceous might look very different on a map, there are many similarities to today. Remember how I mentioned that upwelling of nutrients that fed a whole web of species, including mosasaurs? Well, tons of people living on Earth today rely on similar ocean upwellings.
How can these fossils inform how to be stewards of our world today?
Well, an extinction event happened 66 million years ago and you lost the top consumers in there. We're not in any imminent danger of being hit by an asteroid now, but perturbations happen. And so overfishing or poor husbandry of a modern upwelling system can disrupt it.
If we damage our ocean food web, the Earth will probably recover. After the mosasaurs died out with the extinction event that killed the dinosaurs, whales popped up to take their place. But that took around 16 million years. So our planet will likely heal, but humans might not be around to see it.
Science magic show, science magic show, science magic show.